Line. It's 2020 right now. Don't adjust your clocks. It may say it's 2019 on the calendar, but if you needed any proof that the 2020 presidential election is right here, right now, just take a look at this.
Government is supposed to be for the people and by the people and all
for the
people.
You know what's interesting about this group is I've been doing this for 30 years. I know what I'm doing. You come in here and you say it has to be my way or the highway. I don't respond to that.
Well, that was California Senator Dianne Feinstein getting schooled by children on the Green New Deal in a now viral video. What's that got to do with 2020? Well, you'll be shocked to learn that an unedited version of that video exists, which, in context, makes the senator look less like the villain in Hansel and Gretel. But it's just one example of recent Dem-on-Dem crime. In this case, environmental activists confronting the California Democrat and posting her edited and seemingly smug response on social media. And this kind of stuff is only going to heat up as Democrats try to outleft each other on and off the campaign trail and prove their progressive bona fides. This is a fight for the heart and soul of the Democratic Party, yes, but it's also, may I remind you, supposed to be a fight for the White House. This kind of stuff isn't a good look. Just take a look at some of the latest headlines from the campaign trail. Bernie once praised bread lines 40 years ago. Amy Klobuchar ate a salad with a comb in 2008. Kamala Harris says she won't apologize for prosecuting child molesters. Well, I would hope not. Reparations to become the new litmus test for Democrats. If I'm Donald Trump, I'm feeling pretty good about my chances. As long as the media keeps zeroing in on these dumb plot lines, and as long as Democrats spend the next year talking about the things most Americans don't prioritize, and as long as candidates sound more like they're running for president in 1950 Russia instead of 2019 America, Trump's got this one in the bag. And that should be worrisome to Democrats. After all, President Trump is at record low approvals and he's facing a dozen different investigations. And yet, Elizabeth Warren is talking about reparations. The media is talking about Amy Klobuchar's salad comb. A former prosecutor has to defend her record of prosecuting criminals. This is all good for Trump, guys. Trust me. Here's the deal. Instead of playing right into Trump's hands, Democrats have to seriously sort out their messaging. Are they running for an audience of one? Amazon job killer Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez? Or are they running for all of America? Are they going to kill each other in the progressive primary only to set up a general election can't-win situation? Are they going to be uniters or dividers? Do they want to heal the country or do they want to make the country pay? One thing that would help Democrats sort through all of this, four letters, J-O-E, Biden that is, and fans of history will get that affectionate math joke at his expense. But whether he gets in or out is crucial to Democrats figuring out what they're running on. Biden's presence or absence in the Democratic primary will serve as a line of demarcation. If he's in, there's a clear distinction, both in tone and substance, between the far-left candidates and a more moderate one. Right now, Klobuchar is sort of filling that lane, but Biden would own it. If he doesn't get in, then there's no real governor keeping the other cars in the race at a safe speed. Harris and Warren and Bernie will zoom off to liberal la-la land and pull the rest of the candidates with them. And you'll have a Democratic primary that is unrelatable and a Democratic nominee that can't win a general election.